All right, everyone, welcome to today's tutorial on how to make your own thumbnail on YouTube. So today I'm making your own thumbnail on YouTube. I am going to show you exactly the steps on exactly what to do. And so what exactly is a thumbnail? This is your thumbnail, and you notice when you ever upload a video, you'll probably come to something that's like this. It's actually one of my pages I use for my my capture pages and stuff like that. But I'm going to show you how to customly upload your own video. And if you go inside your editor inside of YouTube, you're going to see a spot as soon as my computer feels like loading. But there's going to be a little link down here. It says custom thumbnail. This is where you are going to use this custom thumbnail. But since my computer's acting slow, okay. Of your next step is going to go to pixlr.com and wait for the upload. And I have already preset some of the stuff for this. Could be a quick tutorial, and you don't have to hear me talking all day. But from here, you're gonna there's gonna be a spot where it says products. And from there, you know, scroll down, and you're going to hit the web version. You want to Pixlr web. And then you wait, and there's a part that says launch web. You do not want to express, so you want to scroll down where it says Pixlr editor. You want to launch web app. As soon as you launch the web app, you're going to go through a couple of these things. A couple options, and you want to create new image, and you're gonna name it just like you do anything else. Let's go all the way down, and you're gonna use the movie 720. Then you have that. You just hit OK. But from here, that's all I needed to show you inside there. But if when you want to upload a image into there, you can hit Open Image. Or you can drag into your files and just drag and drop, just like you would do in Photoshop. You don't use Photoshop. But next, you know, click on your image. Say that you want to expand it to free transform. So make it bigger or smaller. You're just going to hit. So you hit edit. And free transform, or you can hit Control T. I like Control T. It makes it a lot smoother when you're actually doing this. You want to hit Shift. So I say you're free transforming, and you want to hold the Shift key, and you want to hit on your mouse or on your pad of the left side, and you hold that down, and you gotta do it together. But from there, you just hit enter, or you try clicking on image, it'll tell you something different. But from here, you want to come over to the actual Marquee tool. And you want to hold this all the way down, and it's not working for me. So you want to hold this down, and how far you want it. Then you can pick any color that you prefer. I usually use red because that's what I'm going to be going for most of my thumbnails, trying to keep them constant where people know who I am. So there, then you're going to click on the bucket tool. And you click on it, then you just hit it. Then you're going to hit Control D to get off the dancing ants or the little square image that you see around. Then you're going to hit this, but I am going to pause it for a minute. So your next step is going to hit this where it says A. This is your type tool, and inside your type tool, you're able to write text, and you'll have a little image that's going to be popping up. I'm just going to make this short, say Paul And then you can choose your size. And then if you want to bold it, italic, bold, and italic, let's just do bold and italic, right? And so you'll go back to the move tool, or you hit V, I think the shortcut is. And my internet is going really slow. See, this is the reason. You know what? I got to change the color. So I change the color. You just come over here where it says color. You don't double click on it. We'll just hit yellow. Because that's what I usually choose. And from here, it says layer styles. You know, click on that. And do a bevel. Click on it for more options. I use outer. And I'll show you what the difference is in all of them. See, outer, it gives you more of a bold. Say if you want a drop shadow in it, you can actually control your drop shadow. Then hit OK, and obviously, if you're just gonna maneuver around everything to the way you like it and what and how you don't like it. Overall, this is the end of the video of how to make a thumbnail on YouTube. This is very easy and down to the point. I'm not going to keep you on here all day long. I just try to do a short tutorial. I mean, in tutorials like this, it takes a little longer just because there's more information. But right now, what I want you to do. I want you to click down and subscribe to my channel and comment down below and share my video if this was helpful for you. And I'll see you on the next one. All right, everyone. Have an awesome day.